Sir Ellis Clarke made an immense contribution to the history of Trinidad and Tobago in the field of politics, law and sports. A man of great humility, Sir Ellis is one of the greatest statesmen to grace Trinidad and Tobago. Ellis Emmanuel Innocent Clarke was born on the 28th of December 1917 in Belmont, Trinidad. He was educated at St. Mary's College in Port of Spain. Ellis Clarke excelled at mathematics and won an Ireland scholarship in 1938. This moment of great personal triumph took place a year after a Grenadian-born spiritual Baptist preacher named Tubal Uriah Buzz Butler led a series of labor riots in Trinidad. Clarke's education at tertiary level would take him into the field of law. He studied at the University College of London, where he received a Bachelor of Law degree. Clarke was then called to the bar at Gray's Inn. At the age of 24, he decided to return home to private practice in Trinidad. Clarke had pursued his law studies in England, which was at the time gripped in the teeth of war. Leaving England in 1941 for the West Indies was no easy matter. Nazi U-boats were prowling and sinking ships in the Caribbean. Clarke, however, made his way home safely and started private practice in Port of Spain. After more than a decade of private practice, a career in the civil service beckoned to Ellis Clarke. In 1954, he was appointed Solicitor General, a post he held until 1956. He was then promoted to Deputy Colonial Secretary, where he served from 1956 to 1957. Then, at the age of 40, Ellis Clarke was appointed as Attorney General of Trinidad and Tobago, one of only a handful of locals to hold a post up to that time. He would hold that post from 1957 to 1962. Clarke's rise through the civil service came during a time of massive political change in Trinidad and Tobago. The 1950s saw the rise of party politics in Trinidad and Tobago. Notably, in 1956, a new party, the People's National Movement, came to the fore under the leadership of Dr. Eric Williams. In 1962, Trinidad and Tobago would shake off colonial rule and become an independent nation. While all of this was going on, Clarke's career continued to flourish. In 1960, while Clarke was Attorney General, came the news that he was to be invested as a companion of St. Michael and St. George by Queen Elizabeth II. In the first decade after independence, Clarke would serve as Trinidad and Tobago Ambassador in various postings, including the US, Canada, Mexico, and the Permanent Representative to the United Nations. One of the notable moments in his career was presenting his credentials to the U.S. President John F. Kennedy during the Cuban Missile Crisis in October 1962. His meeting with the U.S. President came as the world teetered on the brink of nuclear war. At this time also, Ellis Clarke played a major role in the construction of Trinidad and Tobago's 1962 Independence Constitution. This played a massive part in easing the country out of colonialism and into nationhood. In 1972, after stellar careers in law, the civil service, and in diplomacy, Ellis Clarke received two massive honors. He was awarded a knighthood by Queen Elizabeth II and became Sir Ellis Clarke. He was then named Governor General of Trinidad and Tobago, succeeding Sir Solomon Hoshoy. In 1976, Trinidad and Tobago became a republic. Sir Ellis Clarke was unanimously elected as Trinidad and Tobago's first president. Sir Ellis was re-elected in 1981 and completed his second term in 1987 when he was replaced by Noor Hassan Ali. Sir Ellis Clarke would serve as president for 10 years and 230 days, the longest term of any of this country's six presidents to date. The major part of his presidency coincided with a period of economic prosperity for Trinidad and Tobago as the island benefited from booming oil prices from 1972 to 1983. Another major highlight of his time as president was the visit of Pope John Paul II in 1985. This was the first time a pope had ever visited Trinidad and Tobago. Sir Ellis was married to Lady Ermyntrude Clarke for close to 50 years, until her death in 2002 at the age of 81. The couple had three children. Sir Ellis was a dedicated father and grandfather. He spent several months in London with his daughter Margaret Anne's family each year. An avid horse racing fan, Sir Ellis was the owner of one of the most loved horse races to grace the local turf. The name of the horse was Clown Prince. Horse trainers at the Queen's Park Savannah had vivid memories of Sir Ellis walking across the road from President's House in the early hours of the morning to watch his horses train without a security detail. After demitting office, Sir Ellis remained active in national life. He advised on political and legal matters, including matters on constitutional reform. At international level, he advised on Australia's Republican Advisory Committee in 1993. On November 24, 2011, Sir Ellis suffered a massive stroke. He was hospitalized but never recovered. He died on the 30th of December, 2 days after his 93rd birthday.